My name is Johan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate the AWS IoT integration. So for this demonstration, I have a very simple app using the Node, and the Node is sending temperature and light levels. And for downlink, I can change the color of the LED. And you can find the link to the sketch and the payload function in the link below. So this is what the Node is sending, the raw payload, the light level, the color of the LED, and the temperature. So let's get started with configuring the integration.
So go to our website, click Learn to go to our documentation, go to Applications, and then on the left under Integrations, you will find AWS IoT. So this is the documentation about this integration, and we have a very handy quick start, which guides you through configuring the integration in your account. And we also have links here that bring you to the AWS region to deploy the integration there. So click on the region, and here you have the CloudFormation Create Stack Wizard. And this is basically just the configuration to configure the integration in your account. So enter your app ID. So in this case, minus Johan-dev, and enter the access key. So you can find the access key in the console. So just copy it and enter this in the wizard. So account server, discovery server, that's all default for the public community network. Then you enter the environment name. This can really be anything, probably just your app ID, the instance type. You need to select an SSH key to have access to the EC2 instance that is running your integration. And then we have some settings about synchronizing the device registry. So it's enabled by default, but you can also disable it if you only want to bridge uplink and downlink data. But enabling this really enables you to synchronize the device registry of the Things network with your AWS IoT Things and vice versa. So finally, click Acknowledge, because we're going to create some resources in your account, and click Create. And now the CloudFormation deployment is in progress, and this takes about 6 minutes to complete.
When the stack has been deployed, the status says Create Complete. And this means that the integration is now running in your AWS account. So let's go to AWS IoT.
Then go to Services, and under Internet of Things, you will find AWS IoT. And here you can manage all your things. So click Manage, and then you'll see all the things that have been synchronized with the Things network. So this is an existing device, but you can also create a new device. So click Create, create a single thing, and then enter a name of your new thing. So for example, new node, and select the thing type. So in this case, LoRaWAN, that is a thing type that's created by the integration, and it contains a couple of attributes that you need to enter. So for example, the app ID, the unique dev EUI, which is a 8-byte hexadecimal value. And you can often find this on the device or as part of the batch of devices. So just for testing, and the dev ID. And this is the identifier of the device that as it will be created in the Things network. To enable over-the-air activation, you also need to enter the app UI and the app key. So these are typical LoRaWAN settings. So click Next. You can skip the certificate creation. Just go ahead, create a thing. And then a new thing is created. And after a couple of minutes, the device registry will be synchronized and your new thing will be created in the Things network. For existing things, you can also see all the attributes. So for example, click Node. And here you see all the attributes of existing things. Next is to go to the data. So this is an overview of the data. This node is sending payloads with a light and color and temperature. And we can see this data in AWS IoT. So go to AWS IoT and click test. Here we have to subscribe to a topic, and these are MQTT topics. So you can follow the topic structure of the Things Network because the integration bridges MQTT. So go ahead and subscribe to your app ID and then all the things and then uplink. And whenever a device sends a new message, you will see it showing up here. So this is really the JSON payload of that is received from the Things Network. So it's not only the raw payload, but also the payload fields, as well as a lot of metadata information. What's important here is you see the state payload field. And the state indicates the current state of the device. And the integration uses this to update the device shadow. To see the device shadow, go to the thing and then click shadow. And here you'll see the reported shadow state. So this is the same value as you saw in the JSON that came from MQTT. So this is the reported state, but you can also enter the desired state. This is one of the most powerful features of AWS IoT. So it's really an offline state of your end device. And here you can say which desired values you want the device state to be. So this basically creates a delta state, which is the difference between the reported state and the desired state, in this case also the color. And the next time the network has an opportunity to send the message, you will see here in the Things Network console that it sends the color blue to the end device, and the end device changes the color and reports back that the color is now blue, as you see in the very top. So this is an example of changing the LED of the end device using shadow states. In AWS IoT, you will now see that the desired state and the reported states are the same. So changing the desired state results in scheduling a downlink message.
Using the integration with Things Network and AWS IoT, you bring LoRaWAN to the whole world of Amazon Web Services. And this allows you to use all kinds of services in Amazon Web Services. For example, you can store data in DynamoDB, that's a NoSQL database.
So when you see data flowing and when your devices are synchronized with AWS IoT, it's time to act on the data. So go to Act and click the button to create a new rule. And this rule is going to store the data in DynamoDB, which is a NoSQL, very scalable database. So enter the name for the rule, storage. And here you need to select the attributes in a very SQL-like manner. So the attributes, these are the attributes that you want to store. So first of all, the device ID. Also, we need to store the time, which is in the metadata, and also the payload fields that we are going to store. So the temperature, as well as the light level. So remember that your device sends a JSON object. So this is basically selecting the attributes from that JSON object. And the filter is again the MQTT topic filter. So your application and then all your devices and then only the uplink. You can also enter a condition, but we leave that for now. So this is really the query statement. And this is run against all uplink messages that are published to AWS IoT MQTT. And now you can enter an action. So these are all the integrations that you can enable within AWS. So in this case, we're going to store the data into a DynamoDB database. You can also use a Lambda function or push notifications. So go ahead and click the DynamoDB v2 to split it into multiple columns and click Configure Action. Then you need to enter a table name. If you probably want to create a new table name, so we go to a new tab And here you can click create table. So enter the table name. It could be your app ID or whatever table name you want to use. And then what's important is the keys. So the primary key and the stored key. So the primary key is typically your device ID. So you partition your rows by the devices. And remember that the attribute of the device ID is dev underscore ID. And also add the stored key. And the stored key is typically the time. So this is the time that the message has been received. So we sort everything by time. So you can use default settings. That's all fine for now. And then go ahead and click the create button. So now your table is being created. This takes a couple of seconds. And when that's done, you can go back to the AWS IoT and click refresh to load the tables. And here you will see your newly created table. Also, you need to create a role to set the permissions to actually write data to this new table. So I already have AWS IoT DynamoDB. You can also create a new role. So I'm just using this one and then click add action. And from now on, you can create a rule. And from now on, this rule is created and enabled. And the next time your node sends a message, you will see these values in the DynamoDB table. So go back to AWS IoT and under database, you will find DynamoDB. And go to your table. So the table's on the left, and then your table name, and then items. And here you'll see the very first entry. Here you can also select filter based on the values. So this is very, very easy and simple to get your data from the Things Network into DynamoDB just by using the rules that are built in AWS IoT.
So now we set up the integration for AWS IoT with the Things Network. So in this video, I showed you how to set up the integration, how to synchronize devices between AWS IoT and the Things Network. And I also showed you how the shadow states work. So how you can report shadow states, how you can create a new desired state, and how that results in a delta state that is sent back to the end device as a downlink message. And finally, I showed you how to act on data, so how to store data in DynamoDB, for example. But this opens up a whole world of Amazon Web Services that you can use with your LoRaWAN devices. So thanks very much for watching, and good luck with Amazon Web Services.